and the Lion of Punjab, Lala Lajpat Rai ji, I, Dr. Rahul Shetty, take this opportunity to extend a warm welcome to distinguished students and faculty participants comprising of principals, vice principals, coordinators across varied parts of the country for our online national webinar on the topic En route from transition to transaction analysis, bridging gap between us and them. Organized by Department of Commerce and Internal Quality Assurance Cell of Lala Lajpat Rai College of Commerce and Economics in collaboration with IQAC HR College of Commerce and Economics. Social transactions have always been an outcome of our perceptions, behavior, and intellect in our daily course of life. With the help of transaction analysis, one appeals to strive in achieving his personal growth and development while communicating with others, and has also been a topic of interest for parents, professionals, social workers who strive to enhance their personal and professional capabilities in all walks of life. With global pandemic disruption, and as rightly quoted by Dr. Shetty in an article in today's Times of India, talking about psychiatric medications, he opined that a lot of people are reporting anxiety, panic attacks, depression, suicidal thoughts, and also psychosis, isolation, lack of stimulative social interaction, I repeat, lack of stimulative social interaction, loss of jobs, uncertain careers, are reasons of causing distress among the masses. Through this webinar, we intend to chalk out the methods of enhancing relationships with oneself and with others by exploring individuals' personality and to bridge the gap, that is communication, that seems to have been lost its significance in these trying times. May it be in the quadrants of academics, personal relationships, or self-appraisal, and likewise become more conscious about a thought process and behavior. Before we proceed further, I would request everybody to kindly rise for the national anthem. I request Jyoti to kindly play the national anthem, please.
जन गण मन अधिनायक जय हिंद भारत भाग्य विधाता पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड़ उत्कल वंगा विंध्य हिमाचल यमुना गंगा उच्चल जलधि तरंगा तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
Thank you. I would now request our principal madam, Dr. Neelam Arora madam, Lala Lajpat Rai College of Commerce and Economics, to deliver her welcome address. Over to you, Neelam ma'am.
Thank you, Rahul, and good evening to all the participants. Good evening to Dr. Pooja, principal of HR College. Good evening to our resource person, Meghna Thakur from National College. Delegates and students who have come here to join this program on transition en route from transition to transactional analysis. It is our first collaboration with the IQAC HR College since Pooja. Congratulations, Pooja, for your very, very successful in charge principalship of HR College. And you have a daunting task ahead, and I'm sure you're all geared up, and this is your first event with Lala Lajpat Rai College. I welcome HR College to this collaboration and look forward to more such collaboration with Lala Lajpat Rai College as between the two colleges. Earlier also we had arranged one photography workshop collaboratively. Coming to the topic, Dr. Meghna Thakur has selected a very, very pertinent topic, transition to transactional analysis, en route from transition to transactional analysis. There was a very lovely book by Eric Byrne, I Am Okay, You Are Okay, that spoke of transactional analysis and it spoke of adult, parent and child relationship. In all of us, we have a parent, we have a child, and we have an adult. The adult signifies, parent signifies the benevolent and kindness which they can show towards the younger people. And the child in us is the stubborn, the irrational, the always ready. All these three roles we play at one given time. At one time or the other, we are rational, sometimes we are childish, sometimes we are benevolent like a parent. How this transactional analysis of I am okay, you're okay, and life position help us to deal with mental stress. Today with Corona and unprecedented thoughts have occurred in everyone's mind, even the seemingly healthy and the happy-go-lucky at one time. Aage kya hoga? Pata nahi. Uncertainties are there, and mind games, mind you, are very, very difficult to handle. A physical enemy, we can. It's very difficult to fight, and I'm sure that this talk on transactional analysis, and I think Meghna is also going to talk about Joe Harry window and how well we know ourselves, which will be a guiding light for all of us. Thank you for collaborating with us. Thank you, Dr. Meghna, for accepting our invitation. And I congratulate the Commerce Department, Dr. Lasune, Dr. Purnima, Dr. Rahul, for taking the trouble for organizing this program on behalf of Lala Lajpat Rai College. And all the IQHC and all the other professors who are in his team and who have taken the initiative to start this program. So over to you, Rahul, and thank you and wish you all the best.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you for that inspirational thought process. I would now request in charge principal, Dr. Pooja Ramchandani, ma'am, HR College of Commerce and Economics, to deliver her welcome note and share her wisdom. Over to you, Pooja, ma'am.
Good evening, everyone. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Pooja, we can hear you.
First of all, let me thank Lala College. And Neelam, ma'am, you don't have to call me ma'am. I am your daughter and always will be Pooja for you, always. And my association with Lala College and has been very, very long, 14, 15 years. I used to go to Lala College for taking vivas, assessments. And Neelam ma'am's association with me has been like a mother and a daughter. She has always been helping me, guiding me. A warm person from Lala College. That has been my reason to be a part of Lala College. So it's a family for me. Secondly, all the faculty that are there in Lala College have been so known to me. I mean, I can say that it is my family there. And then we are looking at this association. As ma'am said, yes, HR and Lala College has been doing collaborative programs. Two has already been done. This is the one that are we doing with IQAC of HR College, where the IQAC department of HR College, Commerce Department of Lala College, and the IQAC department of Lala College has done this program. And what a coincidence that they have got a person from National College, Dr. Meghna Basu ma'am, a very good friend of mine. We have been talking on phone and a proud moment that two of my friends, Neelam ma'am and Meghna ma'am, have been my journey that is starting with IQAC of Challenge program under my banner as in charge principal is happening. I congratulate Lala College and the IQAC team of HR College for taking up this event and inviting Dr. Meghna ma'am for this talk, transactional analysis, which is one of an important part of our life, where we say, how do we deal with people? Do we know each other? Yes, there are problems when we deal with each other, but these theories of organizational behavior, if known to us, can help us understand the other person's perspective rather than saying, I am okay, you're not okay. And at the right time when we are going through this pandemic situation where people are stuck at home in under shut doors, where we don't know where is virus, who will catch us and touch us. And we are in this pandemic situation frustrated. But in the families also, there are depressions going on. There are relationship problems going on. I think this is an event that has taken place, a topic well selected by Lala College and IQAC of HR College. And I'm looking forward to this program. And I hearty congratulations to the people of, to all the people in HR College as well as in Lala College. And thank you so much, Neelam ma'am, for always blessing me. Always. Rahul, I cannot forget you. Purnima ma'am, Lasune sir, Vinay Pandit sir. I mean, I hope I'm taking all the names. Mahalakshmi ma'am, they are my family. So I think all of us will work together. And this is just the beginning, ma'am. This is just the beginning. And I promise you, we are all together. Thank you so much. And I wish you all the best and for this program to HR and Lala College. Thank you. Over to you, Rahul.
Thank you so much, madam. It meant a lot. Thank you so much. I would now request Dr. Purnima Sharma, ma'am, our additional vice principal, Lala Lajpat Rai College of Commerce and Economics, to introduce our resource person for today's session, Dr. Meghna Basu Thakur, madam. Over to you, Sharma ma'am.
Thank you, Rahul. Thank you so much. Very warm good evening to everyone present here. I, Dr. Purnima Sharma, thus would like to welcome you all for this online national webinar, along with my colleagues, principal and management. I take this pride today of introducing our resource person, Dr. Meghna Basu Thakur, an eminent educator and an accomplished professional in the field of humanities and management studies. Now, to talk about Madam's academic credentials and degree, she goes about with PhD in psychology from University of Mumbai and a diploma holder in human resource management from Narsimonji Institute of Management Studies. Madam has been head of Department of Psychology in RD National College since 2012. And has also presented more than 50 research papers in national and international journals and books with UGC recognition. If we talk about Madam's contribution to society in general, it is also immense, I mean to say. Madam has been very enthusiastic about working with differently abled students with special needs, such as those with Down's syndrome and autism spectrum disorders. Madam is also very actively involved with various NGOs in Mumbai and in Calcutta. Madam has volunteered at Future Hopes, a British institution with orphan children, with Mother Teresa's Home for Orphan Children in Calcutta, Shishu Bhavan in Calcutta, and also with HelpAge India for Elderly in Calcutta. She has been a resource person and has been delivering lectures at prime institutions of India, and has also been guiding students on various research projects in industrial psychology. She has held prestigious positions in professional bodies, including the Bombay Psychological Association and in University of Mumbai as well. Madam, it is in fact an honor for us to have you amongst us as a resource person. And thus now I request you to enlighten us with your such a contributory experience towards society and community development in general. I thank you once again, Madam, for accepting our invitation for being our guest today. Over to Dr. Meghna Basu Thakur, Madam. Madam, please.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for the very, very magnificent introduction. At the outset, I would like to start today's evening by formally thanking Dr. Neelam Arora, principal of Lala Lajpat Rai College, the Commerce Department under your aegis, and of course, Dr. Pooja Ramchandani, in charge principal of HR College of Commerce and Economics, the entire team of IQSE, Dr. Rahul, who has put in, and the entire team of both the colleges who have put this program, mentored the students so well to coordinate, put this program together. And I can see so many students have enrolled, faculty members and students from all across different colleges have enrolled for this program. And I feel honored to be a part of it. And I just hope that a little bit of contribution and my expertise on this subject can help you all understand this very interesting topic of transactional analysis. And very correctly said by both the esteemed principals that with COVID times, we really need to understand how we can build up our relationship with each other, because we are social distancing ourselves from others, but we are locked in our houses with our family members, with our relatives, and that has had a lot of psychological changes, which has affected mental health, especially in the adolescent group. Rahul, am I audible? I just want to check.
Yes, ma'am. Very much.
Yes.
Very much.
So thank you once again for this opportunity and for giving me a chance to speak on this topic on en route from transition to transaction analysis. I would be very honest is thank that you. Transaction analysis is a very advanced modern therapy that we use as an intervention in psychology as one of the counseling tools. I think I would be addressing the commerce section, and I think students from the commerce faculty who have done Johari window, which is again a very common topic that is taught in BMS, BAF, and the commerce faculty. So I will try to make this whole field of transaction analysis very simple, and I hope you enjoy. The chat box is open, so if you do have any questions, I think you can put it down in the chat box and I'll try to address it. At the outset also, I would like to say that I was forwarded some common questions that students have very willingly put in the Google form, and that's really helped me, and I think that's a very advanced technique, and thank you Rahul for forwarding me those questions, because it kind of helped me prepare and understand what students really want from this lecture today. So I will start. Elvin, can we start with the screen presentation, please? Thank you. So we will start by understanding the term that we have just put on the screen here. What is transition and what is transactional analysis? So Elvin, can we start the screen, please? I'm just trying to start the screen. Elvin, can we do the screen presentation, please?
Ma'am, the presentation is on.
Sorry, I'm not able to see it. Rahul, I think there's a glitch here. Can we just start the presentation?
Ma'am, we can see the presentation clearly.
Okay. Yeah, Meghna, the presentation is very much there on.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, so students, let me start with explaining the simple word. What do we understand by transition? And as we all understand, it simply means change. And we all know that change is inevitable. Change is something that is going to happen in everyone's life. Sometimes this change is predicted, sometimes this change is unpredicted. And we all understand that right now, COVID-19 has absolutely been an unpredicted change in every person's life across the globe. Change in social relationships, change in financial standings, change in academics, change in business, change in stock market, etc. So when we are looking at transition, we are also looking at various changes in our lives, and we need to learn how to adapt to these changes, build up our skills so that our adaptations are good and we do not suffer. So what counseling in psychology does is it reaches out to individuals, families, helping them through this process of change. It also helps in building up values, because every transition in your development stage of life, your value system changes. So next, so transition in psychology is all about adapting yourself and building up your skills. Now, what I have done is very quickly put down the development stages that we all go through. Whether you are in Allahabad, whether you're in Turkey, whether you're in Bombay, or you are in Maldives, all of us have to go through this transition. So transition from the infancy, toddlerhood, preschool period to the middle childhood and adolescent, where you all belong. Now, if you quickly go through what we see as personality changes, when you're in the toddlerhood preschool age, you're basically temperamental. You are just trying to understand facial expressions of people. You learn simple methods of feeling for others, that is empathy. You start identifying your own gender. This is right at the primary preschool stage. As you move up to a middle childhood, which is basically when you're in class 6, 7, 8, and you're moving into the 11, 13, 16 year olds, you will see self-esteem becomes a very important part. You want to be popular amongst your friends. Your peer pressure and peers definitely define your identity. You start comparing yourself, whether it is in terms of what clothes you're wearing, how your friends think about you, do you go to enough birthday parties, etc. This is also a stage. Please let me remind you, a very important stage where autonomy becomes an important aspect. Autonomy means mujhe akele rehne do. Give me space. Most of you speak this way right now. Even my son speaks this way. Mom, it's cool. Leave me alone. This is a typical mark of the adolescent. Next. When we look at the next adolescent stage, this is a stage of young adults moving on to late adults. So young adults, we see they're building in relationships. We get into midlife crisis sometimes. There are career changes. And this stage is when you move from being a single person to being a married person, or you're in a relationship. And that's when you start building your family. Late adulthood is basically, if you see from the picture, I'm not going to call it old age, but I'm going to call it late adulthood, when you've lived your careers, you are now at the point of retirement. When retirement comes in, there are some changes in your income, there may be a loss of a spouse in the family, and the living arrangements, the relationships change in the family. So you may have had, you may be the breadwinner of the family. You may have taken the master bedroom in the house. But when your son gets married and when his family comes in, you may move into a smaller room and may be giving him the main bedroom to share with his family. So this is a transition where values, thought process, etc. changes. Next. Next, when we are moving into understanding transition analysis, we need to understand simple concepts before I go into a little deeper level. Transition analysis was a therapy or an intervention method introduced by Eric Byrne as early as 1950. What does transaction analysis talk about? It's very simple. It just talks about how one person interacts socially with the others. Basically, when we are looking at social interaction, this is the primary trigger of relationships today in society. So you make friends or you break friends. You have a team that works with you, or you work alone. Why do you work alone? Because you don't get along with other people. So transaction analysis may sound psychological concept, but it is basically going to be covering the larger spectrum of how one individual defines awareness, how you understand your intimate relationship with others. Intimate relationship could be you and your mother, you and your father, your siblings, your parents, your colleagues, your peers, etc. So it's very important because it focuses on social interactions of people. Next, moving on, Eric Byrne said that every individual's personality has three ego states. This is there in everyone. Every individual has it. So what are the three ego states? There is a child ego state, there is a parent ego state, and there is an adult ego state, which I will explain a little bit more in the coming slides. So what do we do in transaction analysis? Supposing I was a psychologist, or a counselor, what would I do? This is simply a talking therapy. A session is decided, two people sit across the table, one is a client, one is a counselor, and the sessions are basically done skillfully with question answers, using different tools and interventions to kindly understand one thing, that is the individual's personality and how it has been shaped through his or her experiences from childhood. So the primary premise of transaction analysis, bachpan mein tumhare jo relationships the, bachpan mein tumhare jo experiences the, vahi will be the lying triggering factor on which your personality would have been shaped and carved today. Moving on, so this personality is an important focus that we will be talking a little bit more. Next, when I go ahead to define each of the ego states. Now look at the first one, the parent ego state. Now all your behaviors, thoughts, feelings that are kind of linked to parent figures. Now we all have parents at home and we have seen that most of them use words like should and oughts. So for example, I would tell my son, you cannot do this. You should actually do this. You ought to finish your homework. You cannot do gaming for more than half an hour. So the shoulds, the oughts, the musts, this is typical language that a parent ego state would use. The feelings of the parent, the behaviors of the parents, the thoughts of a parent are all a part of the person's personality. The person also, an individual also has an adult ego state. Now, who is an adult? An adult who is direct, an adult who is rational, an adult who does not behave emotionally, an adult who learns to assess situation as now and then. Moving on to the third ego state, and this is the child ego state. What are the child ego state? When you are a little temperamental, when you get angry, when you behave in a repressive manner, so you throw a temper tantrum when you don't get your things, you tend to be a little obstinate, you want things your way. This is known as a child ego state. Next. So once again, let me repeat that the parent ego state, the adult ego state, and the child ego state, all three are a part of an individual. Now you may ask me before I go ahead that, ma'am, what do you mean by an ego state? Ego state simply means, and defined by Byrne, as a state of feelings. So these are your feelings, and those feelings are linked with your behavior. So if you feel like a child, you will behave like a child. If you feel like an adult, you will behave like an adult. Let me give you an example. Supposing you are stuck in a traffic and you have an important board meeting to go. If you are going through the child ego state feelings, you are going to shout at the bus conductor, the master, and say, ye kya ho raha hai, main kab late ho raha hai, mera meeting nikal jayega, tum log ye ho, government aisa hai, traffic dekho. You are throwing a temper tantrum, but it is not the fault of the bus driver or the bus master because there's a traffic on the road. So your behavior patterns will be linked to your child ego state. But there, if you sit there and rationalize and say that, okay, there's a traffic, I'm going to be late, there's no point in me sitting in the bus, let me get down, let me start walking, let me look at an alternate travel route, that is being rational. So that happens when your adult ego state starts coming up on surface and your behavior patterns are similar. So basically, like I said, three ego states are there in everyone. It makes an individual's personality. All the ego states that you show today are actually an outcome or result of what were your past experiences. How you acted in the past will actually determine on how you act today. So then a student may just ask a question, toh fir main story khatam ho gaya na, bachpan mein jo hua tha, wahi hum abhi bhi karenge. That's not true. Like I said, change is inevitable. If you want to change your behavior, you want to change your social interactions, you can come in for therapy, you can come in for counseling, and very consciously, you can learn how to move your ego states to fit the situation. Next, So let me give you a simple example. This is generally, if you can quickly look at the screen, child ego state uses vocabulary like, I wish, I'm scared, wow, etc. The kind of body language that you will see is generally tilting their head, winking, fluttering their eyes, a little flirtatious. Now, simple things like jumping, curling your hair, giggling, chuckling, you know, nudging your friend. These are simple child ego states. So please have a look. And if possible, keep this in your mind because I will be referring to these acts and feelings. So one side we have feelings, the other side we have behavior. Thank you. Next one. Now we move on to the next one, and that is the child ego state. Let's understand how they work. So let's look at behaving like a child in an adult stage. So for example, you are right now, you are faced with a situation where your attitudes and behaviors are actually a result of your past. So thinking, feeling, and behaving that you did during your childhood is actually what you're going to be doing right now. But your external events that are there, that is actually of a parent ego state. So I'll give you an example. Today you're sitting in the bus, you are getting upset, your child ego state is on the surface, and you start feeling irritated. You start thinking this is not fair. Janmuch ke ye mere saath hi kyun hota hai? You're not able to rationalize. And so what happens? You start behaving in an agitated way. But the environment around you is that of a parent state. So you call the bus conductor and you say that kyun deri ho raha hai? Tum log side se cut karke niklo na, jaldi karo na, overtake karo na. And the conductor or the bus driver says, sir, aap thoda sa relax ho jaiye. यहाँ से हम कुछ नहीं कर सकते, जब मौका मिलेगा हम निकाल लेंगे. That person is actually talking to you in what should be done, whereas you are in a state of a temper tantrum. So please understand what is happening. Next. Now let me explain to you. Next. Okay, so before I can give you one situation and I would then take it. For example, when you were a child and your parents shouted at you, most children spend hours sulking. They would lock themselves in a room or go out getting angry, thumb their legs on the floor, shout back, get really angry. Now, what is this behavior? This is again feeling angry, showing the behavior of temperament or throwing a temper tantrum. And what thoughts run their head? My parents don't love me, my parents don't listen to me, etc. This is a behavior, feeling, thinking of a child ego state. Next, let's look at the parent ego state. Now just have a look. I told you the words like should, must, ought. These are the words that parent ego state generally function on. So don't argue, don't fight, don't worry. You must have heard this in your family a lot of times. Everything will be fine. Don't you dare, etc. Next, looking at this parent ego state, now let's see how. This is a short story between, and let's see how these two friends work. So there are two friends, okay, and one of them lost the mother. So the other friend taps and takes care of one friend and says, don't worry about things. I will help you through this. I really take care of you. I will really take care of you. I love you. Things will be all right. What is happening is the behavior of care. You may have an arm around your friend. You may tap your friend on the back. This behavior of acting like a parent, words coming like, don't worry, things will be all right. This nurturing behavior, this is typically of a parent ego. Next, let's look at the third one. Now, when you're looking at parent ego, the whole question here is of P1 and P2. So I want you to focus on that. Now, like I mentioned earlier already, that every individual's personality has all the three egos in that personality. So I want you to focus on the point which says that in an individual, early parent is formed in the childhood from birth to 5 years. Now, this is important. I will explain how. And in transaction analysis, this is known as P1. So bachpan mein jab ek chota bachcha hai aur wo jab socket ke paas jata hai, electric socket, aur wo chahta hai ki apni ungli socket ke andar dale aur dekhe kya hoga. Immediately the parent from somewhere around will say, no, 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 don't touch, it's dangerous. Okay, number one. Another example, supposing the child is carrying a bowl of food and while walking the bowl is, you know, a little tumbly. The parent will say, theek se pakdo, hold the bowl properly, talk properly, eat properly, don't sit like that, say thank you. So all this we hear right from the day we can understand, right till we are 5 to 6 years. This is the early parent ego where we are being taught the must, the should, the oughts. So this is called the P1. Now let's look at what is P2. P2 happens from the age of 5-6 to the age of 20. This is when we start understanding that there is an external world, there are authorities. We need to understand how to interact with this authority. We need to understand what are the rules of society, what are the social norms. Once again, the must, the ought, the should, but from an adult point of view or from a parent ego point of view. So there are P1 and P2, both of them in an individual. Next. Let's look at the adult ego state. Now you can see over here, there was a boy, he wanted to go to his aunt's house. Most of us today get on the Google map. We type the location and we can maneuver ourselves anywhere in the world. We need not even have a physical map because there's a map on Google on our mobile. So this example of James basically says that he was a very, very rational individual. He had reasoning. He had thinking, he knew how to understand facts, he knew when to take the left turn, right turn, etc. Whatever data he had, he evaluated all the data and rationally reached his destination point, in this case his aunt's house, where he was going for the first time. So this is an example of how the adult ego state functions. Next. So once again, what is next? What is an adult ego? It is basically described like a computer. The adult ego is a rational state of mind. It is a logical state of mind. So basically now we want to try to tell you, and this is again come from Byrne, it doesn't mean that if you are in an adult ego, then you're only thinking rationally and you don't have emotions or feelings. It doesn't mean that way. It means that even if you are in an adult ego state, you are behaving in a very rational, in a very structured, logical manner. You still have feelings, you still have emotions, but the immediate stance is that of an intelligent, rational adult. Next. So now we come to the main part. Let's take a simple example, okay? Think of a situation where you handled it without prejudice or baggage. So guys, since this talk is virtually, we generally do this when we are in person, but maybe you can take this on yourself. But imagine that you had to take a decision and you took the decision with an open mind. So immediately if I ask you which ego state was working, you will say, ma'am, this was basically the adult ego state because you thought of it rationally. You responded to what the question or the situation was and you dealt with it very well. Next, this was the adult ego state. Now, next, this is very interesting. Your question that you may ask me, that ma'am, as students, why should we know what is the ego state? Humko isse kya matlab hai? So this is where the application comes. How do you learn to improve your interpersonal relations? Very, very interesting. You have interpersonal relationship with your neighbor, with your peer, with your seniors, with your juniors, if you are working, if you're not working and you're just young, with friends, with parents. The most important tip of communication is find out whether the interaction is complementary or is it crossed. What do you mean by complementary? When two people are in a relationship, if the interaction is complementing each other, which means if it is parallel to each other, that's going to be a bullseye relationship. things are going to be very good between two people. Both the parties will be satisfied. Both the parties' communication will be completed. Both the parties are going to get the expected response. So one will be the stimulus, the other will be the respondent, or dono ko apne expected communication milega. Because the relationship is complementary, it is parallel. Next, I will show you a simple diagram. Maybe you can understand. So if you see this, there are 9 such complementary transactions. I will not get into it, but if you can just concentrate on the fact that parent-parent, adult-adult, and child-child. So if I behave like a parent and I sit my child down and say, today I did not like what you did in school. You should not have deleted your friend's homework. I did not like it. That's a parent talking, the should and the should not. Then my child tells me, I'm sorry, mama, this was a mistake. I didn't intend to do it. Next time I'll be careful. But I really want to understand that what was actually wrong. I was just trying to type, and by mistake, I entered my friend's cell or, you know, whatever, so her work. Now, if two people are going to talk with the should and should nots, they're expecting. So I would be expecting this response from my son and say, okay, let me explain to you ki ye kyun nahi karna chahiye. There are cyber rules, there are school rules, there are policies. So it's a healthy discussion between a parent and a child because both of us are at a parent ego state. But if I come and I tell my son, next time tumne ye kiya, main tumko gaal pe thappar maar dega. You are a very bad boy. You are a rotten creature. You always do this. Say sorry to your teacher. And the child says, I'm not going to tell sorry. I have not done anything wrong. Do what you want to do. Now, over here, what has happened is the parent ego state was commanding something to the child. The child only allowed the child ego state to come up. And that became a cross. I will give you another example of next. I will give you another example of a complementary relationship. For example, a manager, okay, comes out and tells his employee, you misbehaved with your colleague yesterday, and I don't expect this behavior from you, and I don't want it to be repeated. This is a language very clearly of a parent ego. Why is it of a parent ego? Because he's saying, I don't expect the should and the should not. The worker listens quietly and says, I did not do anything wrong. I'm not going to say sorry. Ghar mein jao. Kuch bhi karo, main to sorry, kuch nahi bolne wala. Now, what is this? The manager was not expecting this. So what's going to happen to the relationship? The manager and the employee relationship and communication is going to break. Why is it going to break? Because this was a crossed relationship. This was a cross transaction. What were the opposite ego state? One was that of a parent ego, that is the manager, and the child ego came out from the employee. So next, if you want to improve it, what should have been done? So you can see the parent ego state of the manager went and hit the child ego state of the worker. Next. So this becomes the crossed method. So what should have happened? So when the manager came and spoke, what should the worker do, employee at that time? I'm sorry, sir. I'll take care not to behave like this again. Now you will say, ma'am, to fir hum haari maan gaye, hum to maan gaye, humne kuch galti kiya. Please see over here, there is nothing said about apology. The worker behaves matured, starts talking like a parent to the manager who's acting like a parent and says, I accept, I'm sorry, I'll take care, I don't behave this way next time. There is no acceptance, there is no apology. He clearly ends the matter in the relationship and says, I'll be careful next time. I'm sorry, sir. Okay, this is a mature relationship. So if you see again, the two lines are parallel over here, and that is what is called the complementary ego relationship. Next, I can give you some more examples of basically how to use. So you can see on your right hand side, these are cross relationships. I will not get more in detail, but it is important that we use transaction analysis to understand your own ego state, how it creates communication barriers. Hum sabko malum hai, the biggest problem in any relationship is lack of communication. So when you do not identify your own ego state, when you don't understand the other person's ego state, there is going to be communication barriers. Your behavior is going to be maladaptive. You're going to be scared. You're going to get into a lot of failures. You will not be able to handle people. You will start thinking negatively, and that will affect your interpersonal relations. So the end summary of transaction analysis is, if you want to have a healthy relation with others, learn to identify your own ego state. Learn to identify your partner's ego state, whoever you are communicating with. Next. So another example over here is, what is the application of an ego state? Now, I think we can understand that self-awareness is one of the most important things. I've already told you, understand your ego state. So if you're with your girlfriend and you're young, and you tell her that, look, I'm not in the mood right now. Aaj milne ka mood nahi hai. You're in one ego state. She says, you don't love me anymore. You didn't talk to me for last 2 days. I think you want to leave me. Not fair. Abhi kabhi mere ko milo. What is she behaving? You need to identify. So you need to understand that, hey, I was acting like an adult, or I was acting like a very mature, rational person, that it's late and I don't want to go out now, but she's behaving like a child. So that's the child ego state. So now there's going to be a cross. So you don't want to lose her. You still care for her. How do you change your communication so that both the ego states become parallel? So it's in your hand. So first identify, then make it effective ways of communication, change, rechange. So this is called transition. Transit from one ego state, move into the other ego state, so that both the ego states functions well. Now, as we all understand, that if you personally have a good relationship, you want to have good relationships in your personal life, it's important that you have healthy thoughts, you have healthy feelings, because jab tum healthy sochte ho, jab tum healthy mehsoos karte ho, tumhara behavior bhi healthy hi hoga. And that comes through the ego state. How do you benefit from transaction analysis in your professional life? We are all going to be working some point of our life, and that workplace is going to be full of teams, collaborations. And when you work with people, it's very important that you become aware of your own ego state, because that will help you to communicate effectively with your colleagues. Professional discussions, professional communication helps you to understand what is the need of my colleague and what is the need of my organization. So this is a very important understanding of social interaction at work. Moving on to the next one. Now we move on to the next aspect, and that is known as the Johari window. Now, very quickly, I think we all have done Johari window. We understand that there are 4 quadrants in the Johari window. When I mean quadrants, I mean 4 different cells. Now, Johari window is very similar to transaction analysis, because again, Johari window helps you not only to be aware of yourself, to identify and understand where you are coming from, and not only yourself, but also understanding others. Please understand, guys, we are all social animals. We all need to have healthy relationships. COVID-19 ka jo sabse bada impact mental health pe hua hai, and that is social isolation, where people have gone into the stage of being lonely, socially isolated, not being able to share. And you have all been reading in the papers, so many celebrities have been suffering from mental health issues. Please understand that these issues are not now. It has been there in the past, but it has become more pronounced because of COVID-19, only because people have not been able to communicate effectively, because online, Zoom, one laptop screen is good, but it is not good enough. So Johari window again is very similar to the transaction analysis. Very quickly, what do you mean by the open self? Open self means I know myself really well, and all information that I know about myself, I'm ready to let others know. When I say all information, I don't mean all your personal information. I mean your personality traits. I'm looking at the second quadrant, which is on the right hand side. It is known as the blind self. This is information that you don't know about yourself, but others know about you. And this is very tricky. So once again, blind self matlab khud ko tumhe malum nahi hai ki tumhare andar ye traits hai, but dusre logo ko malum hai ki tumhare behavior mein ye traits dikhta hai. So we need to understand how to understand and resolve this. The hidden self is the dangerous part. The hidden self, because you know the information about yourself, but others don't know. You have managed to keep these traits secret. You have managed not to share these traits, and this might become an issue in your interpersonal relationship, especially at workplace. Last one, and this is a confused quadrant. This is where you don't know about yourself and others don't know about you. So this is one small hidden corner in your life, in your personality, where you really need to find out and, you know, enlighten yourself. And when you know it, then you will probably allow others to know it. So let's take it a little bit more in detail in understanding relationships. Next. So we take the first quadrant and we introduce you to Johari window. We all know that it was put forward by Joseph Lust and Harrington Ingham. This is a combination of their names. So we take Joe and Harry and we call it Johari. And again, like I said, it is similar to transaction analysis. It helps you to understand relationships much better, enhance it so that interpersonal relationship improves, not only personally but also at your workplace. Next. So I next. Now, like I said, when we're looking at the four quadrants, we are going to be looking at people's traits, people's feelings, people's experiences. We will be looking at the four different, some research call it areas, some research call it regions, some research call it quadrants, but it basically means the same thing. Next. Now, when I use the word self, who am I referring to? I'm referring to the person himself, because he's done Johari window analysis and he knows himself. When I'm talking about the word others, who am I referring to? I'm referring to colleagues, team members, people who are you're going to be working with, or people who you are in relationship with. So to just keep in mind the terminology, because I will be using the word self and others. Next. Thank you. Next. So I just want you to quickly have a look at these words that have been mentioned in the four quadrants. Okay, next, I will take each of them and quickly discuss it. So Johari window has two assumptions. If you want to have a healthy interpersonal relation with your team members, you want to have good interpersonal relationship, it works on two premises. First is, trust can be acquired only when you reveal information about yourself to others. Please understand, it has happened many times in school also. You must have come across friends. You've called them and say, "Kal exam hai, tumne ye chapter padha hai kya?" And your friend says, "Abhi to maine book bhi nahi khola hai." But he may have learned the chapter and revised it three times. Please understand that trust is when you share information. That helps to build trust. That is a very important premise of Johari window. Second is that if you are not aware of yourself, please accept feedback from others and try to learn from that feedback. Acha mujhe ye mere bare mein nahi malum tha, but log ko lagta hai ki main aise behave karta hu, log ko lagta hai. And this would have happened many times with you in your family. Your families would have told you that tu na bahut rudely baat karta hai, theek se baat karna friends ke saath, hey, why do you behave like this, you are not kind to your mother or father, or you're really a nice person, you're so sweet. This awareness that sometimes our friends, family, support group help us with their feedback is important because that builds your self-awareness. So basically, before I go into Johari window, I would like to refer to two words very importantly. One is you need to learn to share information about yourself with others. And two, you need to be self-aware. And that can happen with the feedback from others. Next. So let's look at the first one. Now, this is known to yourself and known to others. Now, do you agree this is one quadrant, which is the most positive quadrant? Because this is open exchange. People, you go to someone. So supposing you have a colleague and you say, you know, ye file mujhe principal ne bola ye file ko upload karna hai. Mera na kaam nahi ho raha, teko malum hai kya kaise upload karne ka? And he says, yeah, just download this, do this, do this, do this, and you'll be able to do it. This interaction is an open source. It is an interaction which will have open exchanges. You will develop liking from the person. Why will you develop liking? Because you know that when you reach out to him or her, that person is going to help you. So trust increases between individuals. Johari window can also be used for understanding group, except group relationships, team relationships, and of course between two individuals. Next, the next quadrant that we're going to be discussing is, so okay, before I go into the next quadrant, let's quickly, okay, to in depth of team members. Now tell me, when a new member comes into your company or a new member joins your team, what is he going to do? He's going to be a little shy. He's going to hold on to personal information. He may be relatively little closed, and his open area may not be that open, which means that he will not want to share. Whereas a person who's been working in the organization for a longer time is already good with communication, with cooperation, etc. So the best thing is to make the new member a part of the establishment is give him feedback, allow him to disclose, you disclose a little bit, let the person open and broaden the open area. So for example, you sit over a cup of coffee and say, mujhe maloom hai tum naye naye aaye ho, main bhi jab 10 saal pehle naya aaya tha main bhi aise hi karta tha, but fir aista aista, you share, you disclose, the person slowly starts building trust on you and the person starts opening up, and that closed area becomes a little open. So that develops trust between two individuals, and similarly with the team. So we've all heard of ice breaking sessions. We've all heard of teamwork. We've all heard of companies taking their teams for a short holiday, overnight trips. What they do there is little bit of Johari window where you open up to your team members. Next. Quadrant two, this is a blind self. This is an area which is known to others in the group, but it is not known to yourself. Now, this could also be ignorance, that you are ignorant. You don't know that this is there, or you may be just deliberately withholding it from others. So again, here, you need to focus on what others tell you, because others are watching you. Like, for example, you know, I'll give you a very simple example. When I was doing, you know, talks before, I had a tendency to hold the mic next to my mouth, because I thought that maybe if I hold the mic next to my mouth, I will be louder and clearer. And I was not aware, I was not doing it purposely, but I was just ignorant about it. And then some people told me that when you have a mic next to your mouth, you don't need to hold it right next to your lips because it comes very loud. Just let the mic be loose and you will still be audible. And if you have doubt, then beech-beech mein pooch lo ki, am I audible? Now this was a feedback given to me, and I realized that, okay, I didn't know about it, and I incorporated that next time when I spoke. So similarly, you may go out, you may talk in a very, very rude manner. You may think that that's just being assertive, and your friend calls you and says, hey, today in the party, you were really rude. You know, I think you should avoid talking like that. You were ignorant. You didn't know. You took the feedback and you tried to change. Next. Next. So we move on to the third one, the very difficult one. It's called a facade. Facade matlab hidden. You have purposely hidden information, something about yourself. The group doesn't know about it. They have your feelings, your perceptions. You have withheld from people. Why do people withhold information? people hold information because they are scared that they will be judged. They are scared they will be attacked by other members. Now, I'll give you an example. Some students have raised this question that if you are a victim of something that is going wrong, others are speaking, but you don't own up. Ye kahawat hai, who will go and bell the cat? Somebody has to take the initiative and bell the cat. Now, basically, in this situation, what happens is you purposely hide it. Okay, you hide it because you don't want to be wrong. You don't want to be tagged. So this, when these kind of feelings and these kind of opinions or perception, you're living and dealing with friends or you're working with a group of people, this is going to cause a lot of damage in your interpersonal relationships because people are then eventually going to tell you, you knew it, but you didn't talk or you hid it. That's not fair. Trust will not develop. Next. We move on to the fourth quadrant. Now, this is sometimes the whole aspect of childhood memories. You know, sometimes we go through traumatic experiences life, and that becomes the unknown quadrant where you forget or you push it down into the unconscious. You don't want to talk about it, etc. So, like, for example, a lot of people ask me that, did you ever want to go abroad and study? And I'm like, I really wanted to go abroad and study, but I never managed to do it. And they're like, but why did you not go? So I think because I would never pass GRE. I'm very bad in maths. And sometimes when I see students now, after leaving maths for nearly 5 years, they are taking tuitions or they're doing self-training and they're managing to crack the maths paper in GRE, GMAT, and they're doing pretty well. And this question always runs in my mind that why was I so scared of maths? Kya hua tha mere saath ki maths ke numbers hi dekhke meko tension ho jata tha, and so I never attempted GRE because maths is an important component in the exam. Now this could be because of that unknown part. I may have had childhood memories which I have pushed it in my unconscious, my experiences with my maths teacher, maybe my experiences with the subject, and that is a result my potential has never been able to be, you know, kind of, it has not enhanced because of my unknown tapped area. So how do I find out? How do I know? So one, I can go to a counselor. Two, I can talk to others. Three, I can have a collective discussion and find out that what is the problem. So a lot of time my students tell me ki ma'am aap ek paper solve karke dekho, pehle khali 2 into 2 puchenge, fir thoda sa difficult aayega, fir aap ek do na aise self training kar lo, aap dekho jitna practice karoge maths utna clear ho jayega. So maybe information from them will help me clear this unknown part and I may do better, but I haven't tried it very honestly. Next. Okay, so let's do one small Johari window exercise. Once again, since we're doing it all virtually, I'm not able to conduct it and get your responses besides just reading it in the chat box. Next, I think y'all can read it. It's very interesting. Next. This is a list of multiple adjectives. Just very consciously be very honest to yourself. Be objective. Don't think too much. Identify 5 adjectives that best describes you. I request all of you to do it. This is very interesting. Just for yourselves, you can identify any 5 adjectives which best describes you out of this list given. I'll give you 1 minute for the activity. Okay, next. Okay, now what you do is you have made your own list. Now what I want you to do is think of any team member, any friend of yours, any team member, and list down 5 traits that you feel you know about that person. That could be your best friend, it could be a neighbor, it could be a parent, anyone. Very honestly, very objectively, write down 5 traits that you want to find, that you want to list down about any one friend or a team member or number of people. Now, since this is again being done virtually, I'm not able to see what y'all have written, but assuming that y'all have done, and we will take the next analysis part. Now, supposing you are going to compare the list, your own personal list and your teammates' personal list. Supposing this was an activity done by a number of people together. It could be done between classmates, family members. You can try it at home. You know, it's the best bond building time at home. So if there is any adjective that appears in both the list, okay, in both your list and the other list, then you know which is this area. This is the open area, because this is what you know and what others know of you, what you know of others, and the others also know of themselves. So this is the first area, the first quadrant. Let's look at an adjective that appears on your list, but it does not appear on the group list. That means this is a hidden area, that you know this about yourself, but others have not written about you, which means you have managed to keep it hidden. The third one, right? Look at the list again, and supposing there's an adjective that appears in your friends list, but it does not appear in your individual list, then this is a blind spot, which means your friend knows this about you, the trait about you, but you don't know it about yourself. And the last one, of course, if there is any adjective that appeared on neither of the list, dono list mein ye adjective appeared hua hai, but it's not there in either of the list, then this is probably an unknown area which you need to discover. Next. This might sound a little different virtually, but once you review it and analyze it, next, I think we can skip this part because we are not able to do. I will give you some real life examples. Okay, just before I clarify, when I'm using the word discovery, how do you discover things? You discover things by listening to others with sensitive communication. So if your friend tells you, a lot of time my husband tells me that, you know, when you talk too fast. Why don't you breathe between your talking? And I say, I don't talk very well. My teacher hai, mereko bahut saalon se experience. And they're like, no, you need to see your own recording. You talk too fast as if you're not breathing. So this is active listening. I have to be sensitive to the communication. Maybe I can change and maybe I can discover. Next. Okay, I will skip this next. I will skip a couple of slides because I want to address the question next. Okay, so what is the application of Johari window once again? Very similar to transactional analysis. One, you will develop your awareness about not only yourself, but it will help you to have a better understanding of others. As soon as you understand yourself best, why you're doing it, believe me, your relationships will develop much stronger. I think someone's audio is on. If you can please mute yourself, thank you. So once again, what is the application of Johari window? Guys, this is very important in psychology. You know, we feel that 90% of people in the world don't know themselves really well. Okay, so when you don't know yourself well, you cannot have healthy relations. When you know others and you know yourself, you will be very, very well equipped to change the quadrants. You will be well equipped to change your ego states. And I'm telling you, before talking, if you just pay attention a little bit to the person who's in front of you and try and understand ki kaun se ego state se aa raha hai, and you change your window, you change your ego state, and I'm telling you, you will have a superb relationship that you can develop. Professionally, once again, I said you're going to be working in a team, in an organization, to build healthy team relationships, to pave your way to success. You really need to understand your managers well, your colleagues well, your juniors well. I'm telling you, maximum conflict happens between two people or between teams is when they are not able to handle the quadrants. So someone is saying something, but you don't trust the person. First premise, relationship gone down. Second, कोई तुमको feedback दे रहा है, तुमको सुनना ही नहीं है वो feedback, and तुम बोलते हो ठीक है मेरे को सुनना नहीं है, मेरे दो कान हैं, एक कान से गया, एक कान से निकल गया. You're not sensitive to discovery. You will have difficulty in building the relationship. Next, so this was the end of Johari window application. Now I'll give you a simple example, and these are very simple examples that we go through every day. Next. Okay, this is interesting. I think we all recognize which movie this is, Barfi. Okay, three people. Okay, now we know already from the story, two girls are attracted to the same boy. The boy proposes one of them. This is a situation not in Barfi, it can happen in anyone's life. Okay, what is happening? I'm going to use transaction analysis. Okay, now supposing you behave like a child. So I forget this other actress's name. What's her name? Ileana D'Cruz. Right. So supposing now three triangle relationship, tino mein, they're best of friends. So if you behave with a child ego state, what will you tell your friend? So Ileana D'Cruz is going to tell Priyanka Chopra that, oh, you're not my friend anymore. You are my best friend. You stabbed me at the back. You played games. Aaj ke baad main tumhare saath kabhi baat nahi karungi, or whatever, whatever. And the relationship breaks because she had her child ego interact. What was the child ego? She was throwing a temper tantrum. She was not thinking rationally. Whereas if she behaved like an adult, what would she have said? Okay, I understand. I also really liked him. You knew that I liked him. But you know what? He likes you more. So can't do anything. I can't force love out of him. So I will support your relationship. Let's still be friends. Now, this is a very rational way of dealing with the situation. You may tell me that, ma'am, bolna bahut aasan hai, karna bahut difficult hai. Please really understand, guys. Adolescent is one age where you need to train yourself how to communicate. Remember, I will give you a simple example, and I think the whole world is talking about it. Sushant Singh was not a psycho. I mean, apart from whatever has been written and whatever's going on, he was not psychotic. He was not abnormal. He was going through a phase where his communication with his family, communication with his friends, started becoming a little deteriorated, distant. Everyone in the interviews are saying, we wish we knew. We wish you reached out. We wish we could help you. So basically understand that if you are not able to transact your social relationships well, you don't communicate in the same parallel line, relationships will become a problem. Next, I'll give you another very general example that we all have. Supposing you want to go abroad for studies, okay? Your parents tell you, "Arey, COVID mein America mein bahut cases ho gaye, California mein to sabse zyada hai. No, you don't go for higher education. Yahan pe raho, yahan pe padho, hamare saath raho." You had dreams, okay? You wanted to go abroad. Your parents had supported that earlier. But now they are not supporting you, and they are the ones who are going to pay for your education, etc. So over here, again, how do you communicate with your parents? Okay, you need to concentrate on which ego state you are in. You need to concentrate on which ego state your parents are in. And you have to make sure that you align the communication with your parents in such a way that they become complementary and parallel and not conflict. If you tell your parents, kuch bhi ho jaye, main to ghar se bhag jaunga, mere ko to jana hi hai, tum mere se pyar nahi karte ho, you all don't care for me, paisa nahi dena, you throw a temper tantrum, you behave in an irrational way. What are your parents going to tell you? Go out, kuch bhi ho jaye, is bare mein baat nahi karni hai, abhi nahi jana hai, matlab nahi. The conversation ends. You've broken the whole circle of communication because you did not know how to change your ego states. So what you can do is, when your parents are behaving like a parent or they are behaving like an adult, you need to calm down. You should not immediately respond. You need to calm down, get yourself on a similar complementary ego state and have a discussion with him so that the discussion is parallel. Next. So this is the way, these are examples of some stressful anxiety situation. Some of you had raised this question that when we are in an anxious situation or when something is developing as a stressful situation, how do we deal? I'll give you a very simple example. Your results are declared. you just realize that you flunked one paper and you were expecting good marks. If you behave like a child, when your child ego state, you'll walk to the principal's office, vice principal's office, college office, and you'll say, "Tum logo kuch aata nahi hai, tum log corrupted ho. Main to pass kiya tha, itna maine study kiya. Teacher favoritism karte. You behaved in a child state. The office people, the authorities are going to tell you, please get out, please calm down. We are not ready to tell. Learn to talk properly. This is not the way you talk to seniors, etc. Whereas if you behaved in a more rational way or in a more adult ego state manner, you would have sat down and say, I'm really upset with this behavior. This is my preparation. Can I have my papers reevaluated? I was really expecting this mark, etc. So that will at least have a communication with whoever the authorities you're discussing. Next. Okay, this is another interesting thing. Again, another anxiety situation tum log ke life mein abhi ho raha hoga. Yeah, I mean, this is an adolescent type. Recently, my sister called me and she said, my nephew is 16-year-old, okay? And he stays in Singapore. So she called me and she said, he has to go for a party. And the mother of the birthday boy, it's not a birthday boy, it was just a party, called and said, is it all right if Ahan drinks? And I'm going to be serving beer and alcohol. So my sister called me and she said, should I let Ahan go? Because I don't want him to drink. So I just told her that he's 16. Number one, what communication are you going to tell him? You're going to sit with him and say, Ahan, peena buri baat hai. Peene se log alcoholic jo jaye, peene se liver kharab ho jayega. You cannot drink. Do's, don't. Advice. He's going to listen to you. He's going to let one thing go in here, come out, get up and say, Mom, please chill. I'm going for the party, whether you allow or you don't allow. Leave it to me whether I want to drink or I don't want to drink. I'm 16-year-old, Mom. What are you going to do? Are they going to cry? You're going to feel bad. You're going to say, oh my God, my son's lost it. He's become a bad boy. This is a problem because both of them were not having a healthy discussion. So what is the other way of having a discussion? You sit down, you talk to your child, not like a child, maybe like an adult, maybe like a parent, or you become a child and reach his child ego state and say, you need to go for the party. I think you should go for the party. Having friends, social support is very important. But do you know that every child becomes an adult and they drink, or if they have to drink, at a particular age? Do you think you can really handle drinking right now because you need to come back home? Will it really look nice and have a good impact on your younger sibling, when you come drunk? I don't think that, you know, drinking will really give you that kind of fun which you could have had without drinking. You have a rational discussion. Hear the person out rationally without becoming emotional. So jaise hi emotions ki ego state andar aa jayenge, that is child ego state, it becomes cross with the person who's trying to rationalize. So again, this is a stressful situation. This may be happening in your lives because you're all adolescent. So whether it is interpersonal relationship, love triangles, love relationship, parent relationship, next time you feel that you're in a little anxious situation, before you react, take a paper, think of Meghna ma'am, try to write down what do you think is the opposite party or opposite person's ego state. Try and practice and rehearse a little bit of dialogue with a complementary ego state. Sit down and have a discussion. And I can promise you, at least communication will go a little ahead. It will not break down. Next. Okay. So coming to the end of the situation, to the conference and the webinar, these were a list of questions that were posed to me. So I'm going to take a few of them very quickly. Next. Okay. So there was a question that when negative things come in front of you in your mind, you've put in a lot of hard work, what do? And you start feeling negative and you want your mind to be balanced. So basically, remember one thing. You can't fight system. You can't fight against everyone. So the best thing is take a diary, take a piece of paper, write down your thought process on that date. So it was 1st of July. I was really angry. Okay, I was so angry because I wanted my husband to come home. I had an important meeting. He kept his phone off and he did not come. What did I do? I locked the house. So when he came at 6 o'clock, he was ringing the bell and I didn't open the door because I said, "Aaj main bhi usko dikha dunga. I'll take revenge." You write down the whole thing. When you've written down, circle what was your ego state. Did you behave like a child? Revenge lena is child ego state. You know, small children, tune bhi mere ko chocolates nahi diye the, main bhi teko nahi dega, tune mere ko ek piece diya tha, main teko half bhi piece. This is a child ego state. So if you start behaving like a child ego state with your husband, and the conflict situation is going to become worse. So identify what were the irrational thoughts. What thoughts came into your mind? He does not care for me. He's purposely come late. He did not realize that it is such an important. Ye sab irrational thoughts hai. Ye bhi to ho sakta hai ki uske important meetings the. Ye bhi to ho sakta hai ki wo fas gaya tha. Ye bhi to ho sakta hai, etc., etc., etc. Identify those things. Secondly, I don't do it very often myself. I'm going to be very honest. But psychology says this is very important. Jab negative thoughts aate hai, the reason behind this is we don't practice healthy habits. Healthy habits means you sleep late, you eat bad, your entire lifestyle is hectic. You are going to have mental health issues. Trust me. What do I mean by mental health? Guys, I have done so many conferences right now and I'm telling you, I'm typically seeing the world. Nobody sleeps before 3 o'clock in the night. I see students sending me messages. The time is 3 a.m., 2 a.m. That means they are online. They're not sleeping. And then next morning when I call them at 8:39, the parents pick up and say, "Arey bichari, bahut thak gayi thi, sorry." They're sleeping till 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, mid-afternoon. Now, if you live an unhealthy life, blaming it on COVID and saying, "Oh, there's nothing to do, ghar pe to rehna hi hai, sona hi hai, karna aur kya hai," you're not giving your body enough rest. You're not giving your body time to cope with the basic balance cycle in our body. That's going to be absolutely an open door for negative thoughts. You're going to get up feeling moody. You're going to get up feeling not healthy. You're going to get up feeling low, etc. Next, so take care of your body and maintain a healthy life. Now, this is an example that I've given you before that, you know, you are a victim of something and others are also a victim, but they don't talk and they don't want to, you know, discuss. This will happen many times in your life. Now, you know, ye tendency hai hamare, all individuals have this tendency. You know, when something goes wrong, we blame others. I'll give you a very simple example. Tum raste pe chal rahe ho, theek hai, aur wahan pe kisi ne kele ka chilka feka hai, and you slip and fall, theek hai? Someone starts laughing. You get up, you look around and you say, "Ye government hai na, India ka government kabhi sudhrega nahi, people have no sense, they throw thing." You blame everything on the government system, people, untidiness of our city, country, road, etc. Same cheech, your friend is walking on the road and she slips and falls. You're going to have a hearty laugh. When she gets up, you're going to tell her what? "You're so clumsy, yaar. Dekho, dikhta nahi hai kya kele ka chilka hai." So, jab kisi aur ke saath hota hai, wahi cheez, you blame it on internal characteristics. Matlab, wo insaan clumsy hai. Wo paidaishi clumsy hai. It's an internal personality trait. That's why she slipped and fell. But wahi cheez, jab tumhare saath hota hai, you are not clumsy. You blame the government and the BMC, etc. So this is a typical way people behave. So please understand that a lot of times, no, we reach that child ego state. We love playing victim. You know why we like playing victim? Because we want people to talk cuckoo to us, to protect us. We act defenseless and say, "Main kya karu, mere saath ho gaya. Maine to padhai kiya tha. Dekho, teacher mere se pyar nahi karta. Teacher so mean. Yeah, she does favoritism. She gave me less marks." You make yourself a helpless victim because you behave like a child and you want that protection, that attention from others. So always remember that if you are a victim, first thing, accept the reality. Don't blame others. Walk yourself into a victimizer's shoe. Ki acha mere saath ye hua hai, inhone mere ko kiya hai, वो क्या महसूस करे होंगे, उन्होंने क्यों किया होगा. ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड द इंटरक्शन दैट वुड हैव हैपेंड. स्टॉप बीइंग pity for your, stop showing pity for yourself, because when you show pity for yourself, you'll become helpless and defenseless. Next question. Someone has posed this question. Oh my God, this is very interesting. I've already explained to you why is in, what is the importance of transaction analysis for a layman. What if you don't know psychology? And today none of you probably knew what Byrne had said, but I think all of you have understood, and I hope you've understood. I'll repeat the two sentences that I said again. Change is inevitable. Change is the only thing which is constant. People can change. So all of you, along with me, we have scope to change. Second thing is, we all have a right in this world to be happy, to be accepted, to be loved, and to be identified as a leader. Now, keeping these two simple premises in mind, you need to understand that if you only change the way you interact with people, you're a little bit more conscious about how you move from child to parent, parent to adult, back, your relationships are good. And that means, jaise jaise time change hoga, jaise jaise log change honge, you should change. I'm sure, I'm telling you guys, I'm really being honest with you. My father passed away a couple of months back, you know, and he was in my house, and one day he left the geyser on, okay? He took a shower and he came out and the geyser was on. I came back from work, I went to wash my hand and I saw the geyser on. I'm telling you this with my personal experience. I got really upset and I told him, Dad, what is wrong with you? Yaar, geyser on hai, it's going to burst. There could have been an accident. Kitna electricity bill waste ho raha hai. What is wrong with you? And he was sitting on the bed and he just looked at me and he said, sorry, bhool ho gaya. Now this was my father. You know, when he reacted like that, it hit me so badly, because this was my father, who was such an assertive, strict person, would have probably told me that, what is your problem? Kuch hua hai kya? Keep quiet, go and put it off. This man, at his old age, just turned around and like a child and said, sorry, bhool ho gaya. Immediately, I had to change my ego state and I had to say, sorry, Dad, I mean, mujhe, you know, I should have been more careful. I should have called you and told you, sorry, next time just be careful, you know, kuch accident ho jata toh I was at work. So you need to learn how to change your ego states, and you need to learn how to, you know, interact with people. Next. Okay. So can we analyze a gap between, I think this question was a little different to the webinar, but I will still answer it, between online and offline schooling. Of course, there is difference. You know, online is when you meet the teacher online. The teacher doesn't know, right now, I don't know whether Yashpal Arora is there. I can see him, but his video is off. So I don't know whether he's having chana, whether he's sleeping, whether he's actually there or not. I just assume he's there. So right now, what I'm looking on the screen is my own self. And as a teacher with 22 years of experience taking classes in the class, this makes me a little uncomfortable, because I don't know what are your facial feedbacks. I don't know what you're understanding. I can see some chats, but online classes are going to be a whole composite and comprehensive of all these, you know, no face-to-face interaction. So offline school, of course, would have been different, where the parent, I mean, the, you know, the teacher takes more individual care of the child. The interaction, the participation levels are completely different versus online. I'm not criticizing the online method, because this has become a new normal for us, but I personally prefer the offline schooling. So there is a difference, right? Next. Okay, how to make young teenagers understand the importance of studies. Again, this is a little out of context question, but I'll still answer the question. There is a very strong negative attitude of most students towards academics, and there is a whole understanding that padke kya hoga, padke kiska bhala hua hai, why study? And you know, this is now a very strong dilemma, that if college and all is going to be online, then what's the point of studying, etc. Now, over here, it is very important that family people play a very strong role model at home, because, I think when family plays a very positive role at home to explain that education is one of the most important things that decides your future, I think teenagers understand. Like, for example, I am a teacher and I believe in discipline. I also have college work. I maintain a routine. I finish my work. So my child sees that, you know, I'm working during the day, etc., etc., etc. So he learns discipline by role modeling me. So I guess teenagers can understand. Parents can play a role over here. Next question. Again, can transaction analysis be used during COVID? And I mentioned this and I told you that very important, because you need to hang in there, guys. All the adolescent kids, all of you need to understand that please hold on. Things will get better. You can cope with this COVID stress. I know it is very easy to say that be optimistic, be hopeful. But I'm telling you guys, 2 days back, we had a seminar on, COVID warriors. Now, COVID warriors, just imagine a 22 or 23-year-old girl, young intern, coming out of a college, wanting to do finished MBBS. कितने सपने बेचारी के होंगे कि मुझे ये करना है, ये करना है, ये करना है. And then comes in COVID and doctors tell her 24 hours, 32 hours, 72 hours, you have to stay in the hospital. Forget your specialization. COVID के patients को take care. And she was telling me that the patient is sleeping on the floor. When you put the pipe inside the patient's throat to do a endoscopy test, the patient is going to cough. So as much as you're wearing the PPE suit, the virus is so small that, you know, it can just affect anyone. But then she's a doctor. So she has learned to be strong, hopeful, optimistic, and she has helped. So transaction analysis will help you to understand that you need to learn to behave like an adult. You need to understand that you can deal with every situation. Next. I have already discussed how transition and transactional analysis takes place. Next. Okay, so this is going to be my concluding slide. Some of you have asked that if you have learned anything from today and if it has been a little helpful and you really want to change your interpersonal relationship with others, then how do you help yourself to develop transaction analysis? Everyone does not have to go to a counselor. You can read self-help books and develop the skill of learning different ego states. So these are some resources that you can refer to. I will be submitting the presentation to the college. So you can take this down or you can take a screenshot, you can click a picture. These are very good books written. Some of them have been written by Eric Byrne, the main founder of transaction analysis. And this will basically show how you interact with people, how people play games, we use words like shrewd, manipulative. Zindagi mein tumhe har tarike ke log milenge, kuch seedhe, kuch manipulative, kuch shrewd, kuch pyare. If you know how to deal with transaction analysis, you will learn exactly how to deal with your partner, with your colleagues, and I'm sure all of you will have a good career, a good personal life. Also remember that, self-therapy, this is a new modern method. They say that, if you know how to do self-therapy, then you are the master of everything. You don't have to reach out to anyone because you know how to help yourself. So I once again take this platform to really thank the organizers. I think Dr. Rahul Shetty has done a great job in coordinating the entire webinar, and he's been with me with the questions, with the timings. I really thank him, and the webinar would not have been possible without the blessings and the permission and giving me such a large dais. So thank you once again, Dr. Neela Marora and Dr. Pooja Ramchandani, for giving me this opportunity to share my understanding of transaction analysis. Thank you to all participants to patiently be sitting through. I know I've crossed the time by 9 minutes, but like I said, transaction analysis says, be a little rational, and thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It was really a wonderful session, a fantastic session. Or 10 minutes bhi chalte the, no problem. So we can skip the question answer session at present, but definitely a formal vote of thanks. I would now request Mrs. Geeta Sahu, Madam, Assistant Professor, Department of English, HR College of Commerce and Economics, to kindly give the concluding remarks and propose a formal vote of thanks. Over to you, Geeta, Madam.
Thank you, ma'am, for being here this evening. And in the context of the Johari window, which was put forth by Joseph Luft and Harrington Ingham in 1955, you have very beautifully explained the concepts of transition and transaction. And the three states of egos of the parent, adult, and child. And also, you emphasized on improving communication and interpersonal relationships, which would be helpful both on the domestic as well as the work front. And an interesting exercise with the help of a few adjectives where one could really understand all the four quadrants of the Johari window was extremely interesting. So thank you, ma'am, for this lucid presentation. And on behalf of the internal quality assurance cell of both the colleges, Lala Lajpat Rai College, as well as HR College of Commerce and Economics, it is indeed my proud privilege to propose a vote of thanks this evening. I would like to thank our resource person, first of all, for this brilliant presentation. A sincere thank you to the trustees and the managing bodies of both the colleges. Without the undying support of both the principals, Dr. Neelam Arora, as well as Dr. Pooja Ramchandani, it would have been impossible to conduct a webinar like this. I would also like to acknowledge the support of the vice principals, Mrs. Vidya Bhide, and the additional vice principal, Dr. Purnima Sharma of Lala Lajpat Rai College, as well as Dr. Naveen Punjabi of HR College. A big thank you to the organizing team, the members of the internal quality assurance cell of both the colleges, and a special mention must be made of for Dr. Vinay Pandit as well as Dr. Jasbir Sudhi, who have been coordinating and leading the organizing team. Our student volunteers here have been extremely enthusiastic and have been working round the clock to make this webinar a big success. So thank you, students. And lastly, I would like to thank the participants. We've had a huge response over here with more than 400 registrations from four countries and 22 states across India. Lastly, I request all the participants.
So it means it has been an international webinar.
Yes, it has been an international webinar.
Yes.
Very good. Meghna, your talk was very nice and wonderfully lucidly explained, I must say.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Meghna,
so much.
Are you there?
Yes, I'm there. Yes, ma'am.
True essence of transactional analysis and the parent-child adult relationship. So thank you for accepting our invitation.
Thank you so much for this offer, ma'am. Thank you. I really enjoyed. This was a mixed group of students and teachers. So I had to kind of maintain balance. I couldn't go too much with, workplace examples. I wanted to make it a little light for students also. So with all the challenges of a virtual presentations, I really once again thank the entire team, the entire IQAC team, both the college organizers, trustees, both, all the vice principals. I really feel that the program has gone on well. And the coordination done by the students, I did not see a single part. You know, the great thing is that my eyes were also on the participant number. Sometimes, you know, they drop because if you're boring or they are bored. But I was seeing consistently that was the number was constant. And I think this is all because of the excellent coordination done at from both the college levels. Thank you so much. Thank you. I really appreciate this evening today.
Yeah, sorry, you can continue.
No, I request all the participants to fill up the feedback form within the next 10 minutes and your e-certificates will be sent to you after 10 days. So thank you everyone for joining us this evening for the webinar.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.